My dear students, today I want to discuss an important property of complex number, and this property is conjugate of complex number. Let us start. What is conjugate of complex number? Suppose z is equal to a plus ib. Be a complex number. Then the conjugate of z is denoted by z bar. We read it as z bar, and is equal to a minus ib. So conjugate of complex number is a complex number in which the connecting sign of real part and imaginary part is opposite. The conjugate of a plus ib is a minus b, and conjugate of a minus ib is a plus ib. In this way, you try to understand. Again, you listen me. If z is equal to a plus ib, a complex number, then the conjugate of j is denoted by z bar and is equal to a minus ib. If z is equal to a plus I minus b, then its conjugate is a minus ib. So if the complex number is a minus ib, then its conjugate will be a plus ib. So in this way, we can find the conjugate of complex number. In short, we can remember it in this way. If z is equal to a plus ib, then its conjugate will be a minus ib. The conjugate of a number, we will say that the conjugate, in a conjugate of number, the sign between real and imaginary part will opposite. So now, you can see from this example, if z is equal to 3 plus 4i, z is equal to 3 plus 4i, then z bar is equal to 3 minus 4i. Now I want to discuss some properties of conjugate number. It will be beneficial for you. So, z bar is equal to z. Z plus z bar is equal to twice real part of z. Z minus z bar is equal to twice imaginary part of z. Z is equal to z bar if and only if z is purely real. Z plus z bar is equal to zero. This implies z is purely imaginary. Z into z bar is equal to real part of z square plus imaginary part of z square. This property is very, very important. And z1 plus z2 bar is equal to z1 bar and sum of z2 bar separately. Similarly, z1 minus z2 bar is equal to z1 bar minus z2 bar separately. And also, the product of z1 and z2, the conjugate of product of two complex numbers is equal to product of corresponding complex number separately. Z1, Z2, the conjugate of Z1, Z2 is equal to conjugate of Z1 by conjugate of Z2 separately, where Z2 is equal to not zero. These properties are very, very important. Now I want to discuss the proof of properties. You must solve the problem, because by solving the problem, you will learn a lot. You will learn a lot definitely. So you must do the problem. Do the all property. Do each and every property. Now, z is equal to a plus ib, z1 is equal to a1 plus ib1, and z2 is equal to a2 plus ib2. We consider this notation in entire problems. Z is equal to a plus ib, z bar is equal to a minus ib. So, conjugate of a minus ib, conjugate of a minus ib is conjugate of is equal to a plus ib. So conjugate of z bar of z bar is equal to z. Z plus z bar, of course it is twice, that is twice real part of z. Similarly, z minus z bar, it is twice I imaginary part of z. Since z is equal to z bar, then what do we observe? We observe that imaginary part of z is equal to 0. If two complex number here, the complex number and its conjugate both are equal, then what does it mean? Imaginary part is equal to 0. Complex number is purely real. In this way, we'll here prove this theorem. Now, I want to prove next properties. Z plus z bar is equal to 0. Z plus z bar is equal to 0. Z is equal to a plus ib. Z bar is equal to a minus ib. Is equal to 0. This implies a is equal to 0. This implies if z plus z bar is equal to 0, then number is purely imaginary. Real part is 0. So number has only imaginary part. Z into z bar is equal to real part of z square plus imaginary part of z square. So we have a1 plus a2 plus I b1 plus b2. Then conjugate of z1 plus z2 is a1 plus a2 minus I b1 plus b2. And if you here, what do you observe? A minus I b1 and a2 minus I b2. So a minus I b1 is conjugate of a1 I b1 plus conjugate of a2 I b2, that is z1 bar plus z2 bar. So conjugate of z1 plus z2 bar is equal to z1 bar and z2 bar separately. Now we have z1 minus z2. Z1 minus z2 is equal to a1 minus a2 plus I b1 minus b2. So conjugate of z1 minus z2 is equal to a1 minus a2 minus b1 minus b2. That is a1 minus I b1, a2 minus I b2. That is z1 into z2. Z1 minus z2, not into, is equal to z1 bar minus z2 bar separately. So in this way, we can prove the difference of two complex number, conjugate of difference of two complex number is equal to its difference of its conjugate separately. Now I will discuss the another properties in next video. Thank you very much.